the competition is a good competition. And I divide the competitions, okay? Eshkol HaZahav is not a very good competition. My opinion. And the wine that got, for me, the best result is a syrup wine, okay? So you're right about this one. But the Teravino, people that are judging there are very high educated and experienced experts. And they know what they're doing. And the good wines get the grades. That's how I see it. You can always have mistakes. But the mistakes could be if you got a silver medal or a gold medal. The wine that gets a double gold medal usually is a very good wine. Maybe there are other wines that got only a gold medal and they're very good too, but it shouldn't be there if it's not a very good wine. And normally you do not get there without being a very good wine. So what happened here is in the 7th century, the Muslims conquered this region, and because they don't drink alcohol, so just destroyed all the wine industry around here. So we cannot find anything, any remnants from this area. Big industry that was around here. And they were trying to find. You sell a bottle of wine for 150 shekels. Just 750 cc wine. Why should you put this cap if all the concept is selling glass, and then you go and put a screw that's crazy.
Very good cork. They say,
give someone to pull out the big cork and let them have his fun. And the fruit in the wine is like the sour fruit, like a red cherry, a red plum, okay, these kind of smell. This is not a typical Israeli wine. You don't see these kind of wine in Israel, almost any. For that reason, it's now going out to France. And I'm not surprised, because it's really, they like these kind of wine.
So this being Merlot, it's a French grape. They export it to Israel and then buy it back in.
It's funny because you can say Cabernet Sauvignon and you get maybe 100 different kinds and types and tastes. Okay, it's really a material. You can do whatever you want with it. You can grow it wherever you want and you can get different things out of Cabernet. So if someone says Cabernet, okay, I bet that if you give this wine with this bottle to any person in Israel and you ask which variety it is, no one will say Merlot. No one. Okay? So, actually, most of our wines are not like this. Even though this is my type of wine. I prefer these kind of wine. Most of our wines are more sweet on the palate. It's less acidic, both in the nose and in the mouth. It's more like chocolate wine. You'll see two very different wines. Okay? But I'm trying to keep a very aromatic wine. I'm trying to keep the wine interesting. Not just the jammy wines you get in Israel, but interesting wines. And this is why we're doing very cold fermentations, very low yield in the field. So these two things give us different wines. I mean, when you test a single vineyard, you see it's a thing you have to learn. I mean, you can do wine without knowing anything, but then you're in the realm of uncertainty. Everything can happen, okay? You can be a very good winemaker, you can be a very bad winemaker, you can have a year of very good wines, very bad wines. It's like luck, okay? But when you know what you're doing and you're trying to repeat it, then things go much better. And for that, you have to learn. You can do it at university, you can do it with courses, you can do it by learning by yourself on the internet, but you have to learn. Okay? It doesn't have to be 2 years second degree plan in Bordeaux. Okay? It really doesn't have to be. I'm trying to produce wine with most maximum 13.5% alcohol. We have a very cold region. We can control sugar level and still have very acidic wine. This is a very acidic wine. We're trying to produce wines that are not very heavy and are more fruity. So if we're succeeding, we can get wines that have strong colors, enough tannins, and enough acid to go much more than 10 years. I'm putting my wines in three categories, three tickets. One is the Odeon. It's a wine for drinking maybe 3-4 years. It can hold more, but I'm not promising anything. Kofna is the series where I do funny things. That'd be things like Chardonnay Cabernet Sauvignon or Cabernet Franc by itself, or Pinot Noir next year, or a single vineyard Cabernet Sauvignon that can last very long times. And Metzada, this is the premium level wine. This is selling in the stores in about 200-220 shekel. This is a wine that we're putting together for a long aging. Okay, so it has enough tannins, enough of everything, and it's very complex.
When I was growing up, the alcohol levels were like 12%, like a wine is 12%, and now usually it's like 14-15%.
It's not right to do 12% here. It might be right in France when you get very cold weather through the summer and many shady days and so on. But here, in a 12% alcohol wine, you should anticipate green smells. No ethanolic maturity. It's usually not a good wine. There are some guys that are starting to do that, and it's very bad, very, very bad. You cannot escape the 13% alcohol. You cannot. You do less than that, you get green wine. If